Please take care of him.
I'll grab my plane, partner.
Deputy, I know there's a long way to go, but everything you do gives inspiration and hope to the Resistance. I can hardly keep track of all the people showing up willing to help us in this fight. It's only a matter of time before we take out John Seed and rescue Hudson. Don't you worry.
Camping out of the Lamb of God Church. The Peggies keep fucking with this place.
I heard that from here. You must have hit one of the cult silos. They're loaded with fertilizer that the Peggies are using to make explosives. Hell, that's exactly what those assholes used when they attacked Nick and me. It's lethal. Knock out everyone you see. My suggestion? Use Nick's plane. He won't mind.
You must like trouble.
Reminds you that
name's Grace. Got word someone was out making life miserable for the cult. You got good timing. See those graves down there? A couple war heroes buried here. My pops was one of them. The Peggies are trying to defile them. They're trying to erase our history, demoralize us, get us to break so we'll roll over. Not on my fucking watch. Ain't nobody gonna touch my pops' grave while I'm still breathing. I'm a good shot, but I need someone to watch my back. They'll be here any second.
Dick!
Check southeast.
I'm good up here. Get on the ground and I'll cover you.
I have eyes on a target.
Thank you.
I'm seeing the target.
Thanks for that. You got time to talk? I owe you. Not a lot of people would have stuck their neck out like that. It means a lot to me. My pops always said, as long as we keep believing in each other, there's still hope. If we stick together, look out for one another, cult will never break us. I ain't about to get all sappy and shit, but if you ever need help, give me a call. I got your back.
That is not the will of the Father. Take them to John. He's ready to hear their confession.
To teach me about the power of yes. One night they took me into the kitchen and they threw me on the ground. And I experienced pain after pain after pain after pain. And when I didn't think I could take any more, I did. Something broke free inside. I wasn't scared. I was clear. I looked up at them. I started to laugh. All I could say was, yes. I spent my entire life looking for more things to say yes to. I opened every hole in my body, and when those were filled, I created more. But it was Joseph who showed me just how selfish I was being. Always receiving, always taking. The best gift isn't the one you get, it's the one you give. Giving takes courage. Courage to own your sin, to etch it onto your flesh and carry its burden. And when you have endured, when you have truly begun to atone, to cut it out like a cancer and display it for all to see. I'm going to teach you courage. Teach you how to say yes, so you can confront your weaknesses, confront your sins. You will swim across an ocean of pain and emerge free. For only then can you truly begin to atone. Who wants to go first? Which one? Yes. Yes. You're not gonna regret this. I promise. Now, before we begin, I think it's only proper that Deputy Hudson goes back to her room. Confessions are meant to be private, after all. I am not here to take your life. I'm here to give it to you. I'm going to open you and pour your worst fears inside. And as you choke, your sins will reveal themselves. Only then will you truly understand the power of yes. I'll be right back.
Read the Father's book, you'd quit yapping.
We've
bearing our souls. Come on, we need to keep the burden of their sin. That is what I'm offering.
Her angels, but she never did treat them all that well.